This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to talk about closure properties in mathematics. So let's look at a question that asks about closure and try to understand what closure is all about. So I've got this question. Is the set of natural numbers closed under addition? Now, all this is asking is this. If I take two natural numbers, let's call them A and B, and I add them together, so I've got A plus B, will the result of that addition also be a natural number? A more general way of saying this is, if I have some set and I take some of the members of the set and I do an operation like addition or subtraction, multiplication, and so on, I do some operation using those members of the set, will the result also be a member of the set? In other words, will I be able to stay inside that set when I write my answer? If I can, then we can say that the set is closed under that operation. If I can't, then the set is not closed. I had to go outside of the set to get my answer. Okay, so to go back to the specific question, is the set of natural numbers closed under addition? I can think of that this way. I've got two numbers, A and B, and they're natural numbers. I start with one of them. Whatever it is, I'm going to count up B more. Now, since I'm counting up, and when I count, I'm just adding one increasingly each time, then I will always be going from one natural number to the next natural number, okay, in the overall sequence of natural numbers. So in other words, if A was 4 and B was 3, then I could just count on my fingers. I could start at 4 and say 5, 6, 7. So I've counted up 3 units, and I've come to another natural number. So it seems pretty reasonable to say the set of natural numbers is closed under addition. Okay, so what about subtraction? What if the question had asked, is the set of natural numbers closed under subtraction? Now, if we can find one example where I have to go outside of the set when I do subtraction, I'm going to end up with a number that's not a natural number, then the set is no longer closed under subtraction. So it seems like a pretty simple way to find this would be if I took a small number, like 2, and subtracted a larger number, like let's say 17. 2 and 17 are both natural numbers, but when I do my subtraction, I end up with a negative 15. Negative 15 is not a natural number, so the set of natural numbers is not closed under subtraction. Let's go on to multiplication. Is the set of natural numbers closed under multiplication? So the first thing I might want to do is just try multiplying a couple of random natural numbers, like 4 and 3, and see if I get a natural number. So 4 times 3 is 12. 5 times 8 is 40. So it seems like there's a chance this could work. I want to think more generally about it. And if I think about multiplication, what I could do is I could say, oh wait, multiplication is repeated addition. So if I have the natural numbers A and B, and I'm multiplying them, really what I'm doing is I'm adding repeatedly a number of A's. The number of A's I'm going to add is B, whatever B is. But B is a natural number, so I know I'm adding whole amounts of A. Well, since the set of natural numbers is closed under addition, and multiplication is really nothing more than repeated addition, then the set of natural numbers would also be closed under multiplication. Okay, and let's do the last of the four basic operations. Let's see whether these natural numbers are closed under division. And if we think of division as repeated subtraction, and we know subtraction is not closed, it seems like there's a good chance that division won't be closed either. And basically, at this point, all I have to do is find one example where I don't end up with a natural number when I do division. So let's say that I'm taking 5 and dividing it by 2. When I take 5 and divide it by 2, I could write the number, the result as 2.5, or I could write it as 2.5. These are not natural numbers. 2.5, 2.5 are not natural numbers. So the set of natural numbers is not closed under division. So that's basically the concept. You may be asked more complicated questions like, is the set of all even natural numbers closed under addition? Or is the set of all perfect squares closed under multiplication? And you would use basically the same process. You would try to logically figure out whether you could say, no, it's not, in which case all you'd have to do is find one example of it not being closed. Or you might want to show logically how it must be closed. But that's it for the basic introduction. So we'll stop here. Take care. I'll see you next time.